Last class we have discussed what is K-map and how to encircle the circle in a pair to get a pair wired active using a 2 input variable, 3 input variable and 4 input variable. And even we have shown map rolling last class. Today's class we will discuss what is overlapping groups. In general, overlapping means that is nothing but a partly coinciding time. But in overlapping in a K-map is nothing but same one can be used more than once, we call it as overlapping. Once again I am explaining, same one can be encircled more than once, we call it as overlapping. That is, in your SOP, we are seeing a simplification of SOP using K-map. In SOP, you know that the output is one can be encircled, making a pair, quads and octet. See, here, overlapping means coincident, partly coincide in time. That is a general meaning. Overlapping in K-map means same one can be encircled more than once. Such a thing we call it as overlapping. Just we'll see an example, then we'll come across what is overlapping in K-map. Okay, this is an example for overlapping groups. F is equals to summation of n 5, 6, 7, 10, 14, 15. For this we have to draw at K-map. By this itself it's across 15. You think this is a 4 input, so 4 input variable, 2 to the power 4 is nothing but 16 squares is possible. So if I'm writing a K-map, that is nothing but 16 square. So they are not given the expression or variables, just write it as W, X, Y, Z. Okay? Here, I have to address the subscript, that is nothing but your min terms, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. This is my addressing of a K-map in your 4 input variable. So here WX, YZ, it's my variable, that is literals. Here I have to address in the form of binary values. That is nothing but 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. That is nothing but your WX bar, W bar, X bar, next W bar, X, next WX. Next is nothing but W, X bar. Here, Y bar, Z bar, Y bar, Z, Y, Z, Y, Z bar. Now we have to map the values for the given number expression. 5, in place of 5 subscripted numbers, I am going to mark it as 1. Okay, next 6, next 7, next 10, next 14. Next 15. Now in the 16, that is 16 squares, I have to find out the first is your octet. Find any 8 ones are there. Then if it is not octet is not present, go for quads. Then you have to go for pairs. So 8, it is not possible of 8 ones, but it is possible of quad. That is nothing but this one, particular one. This is my one quad. Here. Next, only one quad is possible. Then you, after quad, what have we have to check for a pair? What's my pair? Next pair, it is nothing but not this one. One pair and another one here. This is my another pair. Once again, I'm explaining. Listen here. See, for the given input, see the expression, see the variables. If they are not given any variables or literals, just go through the numbers. It is a 4 input variables. So, W, X, Y, Z. First, it represents in the form of subscript, that is your square should be addresses. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, for this expression the numbers, that is the SOP as 1. So here it is 5, I have placed 1. Next 6, I have placed 1. Next 7, I have placed 1. Then 10. Next 14, 15. In your 16 squares, you have to see the first your octet. See any 8 ones are there. If octet is not present, go for quad, then you go for pair. So here I've got one quad, that is nothing but M7, M6, 14, 15. And one pair, 5, 7. And another pair, 14, 10. See here 7, that is nothing but 7 is being, M7 is being overlapped by, that is nothing but 5. So M, that is M7 is being used by the M7. That is 1 is being, I have already told, you are overlapping, nothing but same 1 can be encircled more than once. So same 1, this 1 is used for your quad as well as for your pair. So 1, M7 is used in your quad as well as it is used in your pair. Similarly, M14 is being overlapped by M10. M14 is used in your quad as well as it is used in your, what is the pair. Now we will see how the expression evaluated for this. See here, we have one quad, two pair. So first we will see quad 1, there is only one quad. So quad 1, what are the quads addressing is nothing but M7 plus M6 plus M15 plus M14. Next, pair 1. I am going to see the pair 1. For pair 1 is M5 plus M7. There is one pair is being written. Next, we see for second pair, there are two pairs. So second pair, 2. That is nothing but my M14 plus M10. First we will solve the quad value. What's my quad value is nothing but when I take this particular thing, your quad 4 ones. See here, your horizontally, that is nothing but your vertically, your W bar X, W X. So I have already told in your quad 2 variable changes. So here W bar W, that is a change from complemented to complemented. So these two will be cancelled. My left out thing is here, it is nothing but X. Okay, this is about your vertical. When you go for horizontally, YZ, YZ bar. So Z bar and Z cancels, left out is XY. This is my expression for your quads. Next you go for pair 1. What my pair 1 has, that is nothing but W bar X. In a pair, only a variable can be removed or changed. So W bar X, that is all vertically. Horizontally, what you have means Y bar Z. Y bar get cancelled. My value here it is W bar X Z. See, my value is W bar X Z for pair 1. For pair 2, you are going to see here for pair 2 is nothing but these two. That is nothing but your W X, W X bar. So X bar, X and X bar get cancelled. W as it is. Next, when you go for horizontally, Y, Z bar. So, Y, Z bar. So, my given expression is nothing but what it after simplification you get it as XY plus W bar X, Z plus W, Y, Z bar. Once again, I explain now this expression. See, first you take for a quad. The quad, what are the expression evaluated is W bar X, W, X. So, and this is about your vertically. When you go horizontally, these two, Y, Z bar. In a quad, two variables will be changed from a complemented to uncomplemented or uncomplemented to complemented. Your W bar and W is cancelled. Left out with this X. So, X. When you go this side horizontally, Z and Z bar get cancelled. You have remaining value. Variable is Y. That is for your quad. Next, when you take a pair, pair 1, that is M5 and M7. See the vertically the expression is W bar X. I am writing as it is W bar X. When you go horizontally, these two varies. That is Y bar Z, Y Z. Y bar Y get cancelled, Z as it is. Plus the another pair, that is nothing but M14, M10. When you go, this vertically changes W X, W X bar. So X, X get cancelled, W as it is. In your horizontal way, Y Z bar same. Y, W, Y, Z bar. This is the how the overlapping takes place. That is one, same one can be encircled more than once. We call it as overlapping. And therefore the given expression terms of overlapping. Next topic we'll see redundant groups. See here, next topic is redundant groups. Redundant group is nothing but is a group that is being overlapped by other group. Such a group we call as redundant groups. Once again I'm telling, redundant groups is nothing but a group that is being overlapped by the group is being overlapped by other groups of ones. Such a group we call it as redundant groups. We'll solve a problem, then you can understand how this redundant groups can be used. See, I have already told redundant groups is nothing but a groups whose all ones are overlapped by another group. Such a group we call it as a redundant groups. For example, I have taken an expression f is equals to f, that is f of function of a comma b comma c comma d is equals to summation of 4 comma 5 comma 13 comma 15. By a given expression, there are 4 variables, that is 4 inputs. 2 to the power of 4 is nothing but your 16 squares can be represented in a K-map. So first we'll draw a K-map, then we'll solve all this expression. Here, A, B, C. Now, I'm going to divide it into 16 squares. Now, I'll write a subscripted value. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Once again, I'm explaining. Subscript starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So next you have to write the variables, that is nothing but your, that is nothing but in the form of binaries, that is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Here also 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Now it represents in an expression, that is nothing but A bar, B bar. This is the SOP. So bar means it is 0. Without bar means it is 1. So A bar, B, A, B. Next A, B bar. Next you write this expression C bar, D bar. C bar, B. C, D. C, D bar. Okay, after representing the, that is nothing but literals or variables in the form of complemented and uncomplemented based on your binary system. Binary numbers. Next, you have to represent the function which has the output in your SOP, that is nothing but the numbers 4, 5, 13, 15. So, you represent that one in the ones, others remaining zeros. Here 4, 1, okay, 5, 1, 13, 1. Next, you have 15, 1. So, these are the ones that is given for the expression which has the output as 1. The remaining places you place 0. You place it with 0. Now, you find any octet or quads or pairs exist. So, there is 4 ones but it is not in a quad form. Next, you can go, if there is no octet, quads, then you have to go for pairs. So, here 1 by pair it is nothing but M4 and M5. Another pair is M13 and M15. So you can make another more pair is nothing but M5 and M13, that is M5 and M13. So here M5 is being used by M4, M13 is being used by M15. That is one pair of group is being overlapped by other groups. Such a group, this group we call it as the redundant groups. See, I have already told redundant groups is a group whose all ones is being overlapped by the other ones. Here, this one group is being overlapped by pair 1 as well as the pair 3. Pair 2 is being overlapped by pair 1 and pair 2. Pair 3, pair 2 becomes a redundant groups. For this, we can write the expression that is nothing but, see here, first one, pair 1. Pair 1. What are the pair 1 is M4 plus M5. Next, pair 2. My pair 2 is the pair 1 is M4, M5. Pair 2 is M5 plus M13. Next, pair 3, you have M13 plus M15. So first we'll see one by one, then we'll go for how the expression is being formed. First pair 1. Pair 1 is nothing but M4 plus M5. What's my expression for this is A bar B. That is these two in a pair are variable removed. That is it changes from a complemented to uncomplemented or vice versa. So A bar B. Next here C bar D. These two get cancelled. My expression for pair 1 it is A bar B. Okay. Pair 1 is being solved. In pair 2 that is nothing but here. The expression here it is A bar B AB. So A bar A get cancelled. The remaining here it is B. That is vertically. Next we go. When you see horizontally what you have the expression is C bar B. Okay. Next these two get solved. That is pair 2 got solved. Now we go for pair 3. Pair 3 the vertical expression is AB. Okay. Write it as it is. When you go for what's that horizontally C bar D C D. C bar C get cancelled. The value is remained here is D. So the given expression for this is nothing but A bar B plus B C bar D plus A B D. Okay. So you got the expression A bar B plus B C bar D plus A B D. This expression can be made more simpler, simplification can be done by removing the redundant groups. The redundant groups value is that the redundant group is what is the redundant group here? It is nothing but your M5 and M13. So that group values expression can be removed. That is B, C bar D. Then after removing your redundant groups, the final expression what you got? A bar B plus A B D. Now let's see after removing the given expression, that is your removing the redundant groups. My data look like how it will be seen in the next thing. See, redundant groups with help of a redundant group is nothing but a group is being overlapped. All is once has been overlapped by the another group. Such a group we call it as a redundant group. Here there are three pairs that exist: pair 1, pair 2, pair 3. The pair 2 becomes a redundant group for pair 1 and pair 3. So you after evaluating the expression, you got the final expression with redundant group is A bar B plus B B bar C D plus A B D. See, I took this particular expression. Okay, I have taken this particular expression A bar B. Next one, these two. That is C bar B bar C bar D. So C bar here. C bar D bar C bar D. Okay, here in a pair only one variable can be removed. So what is the one variable that is changes from complemented to uncomplemented? Here it is A bar B in your vertical side, in your horizontal side A bar B as it is separate, C bar D. So D bar D get cancelled. So my given expression is A bar D bar C bar plus. Next one expression being solved. Next for pair 2, the after solving A bar B A B A bar A bar A bar A get cancelled. The remaining it is B as it is separated. You know vertical you have C bar D. I have written same thing as it is. Plus your pair 3. This pair 3. So A B as it is. In your horizontal side C bar D C D. So bar the uncomplemented. Uncomplemented get cancelled. So complemented. Sorry uncomplemented. Complemented get cancelled. The remaining term is D. So D is being written. So this is the expression for your redundant groups. This group can be made more simpler. The expression can be written more minimal or simpler way by removing the redundant group. If I remove the what's my redundant group pair value, it is B, C, bar, D. So if I remove the B, C, bar, D, my expression will be A bar, B plus A, B, D. So this K-map, after removing my redundant groups, the K-map looks like a so there are only two pairs, that is M4, M5, M13, M15. If the question arises, find out the redundant group, remove the redundant group and place the K-map. You have to write the expression. First you draw the expression, that is a K-map with redundant group. After that you have to solve without a redundant group your K-map. So next we will see summary or rules of SOP using K-map. See here. Next topic is summary of all rules for SOP reduction using K-map. That is, you have to follow all the rules in your SOP to reduce to K-map. What are the rules? Mean there are 7 total rules. What are the rules? Means first, before the given the expression, you have to prepare the truth table for the given table. You have for the given expression, you have to prepare the truth table for the given expression or table. Next, draw an empty K-map for the given function. You have to draw the empty K-map for the given function. The variables for this can be 2 variables, 3 variables, or 4 variables, and so on. Now till now we have studied 2 variables, 3 variables, and 4 variables. Based on the function or expression, you have to take it as whether it is a 2 variable input or 3 variable input or 4 variable input. So if it is a 2 variable, then 4 squares. If it is a 3 variable, 8 squares of K-map should be represented. 4 variable input means 16 squares K-map should be inputted. Next up, enter zeros in all left out empty squares. You have to enter all the zeros. So sorry, third one, map the given function after drawing an empty K-map. After writing the min terms for each square, that is M0, M1, after mentioning the addressing code, subscript number for each square, then you have to map the given function by entering ones for the output as 1 in the corresponding squares. If it is a function, has the numbers, whatever number, let it be 1, 3, 6, for that corresponding squares, you have to enter 1 as my output in your SOP. Then after entering that ones, the leftover squares, after entering the output came from your truth table or expression, that is the numbers, that is 1 as the output, the leftover thing should be entered with zeros. Zeros, enter zeros in all left out empty square. After entering the 1 and zeros, now you have to encircle the adjacent one. You have to find the adjacent ones, you have to encircle, you have to group in such a way whether it forms an octet, quads, and pairs. If after forming your octets, quads, and pairs, if you have any map roll, or that is roll the map rolling, or overlapping is there, roll the map and overlap the ones. After encircling the ones, mapping the K-map, and even overlapping is occurred, you have to overlap the ones with the help of a K-map. After doing this, if there is any redundant group is exist, if in your K-map, in a given expression, if any redundant group is exist, remove that redundant group if there is an existence. If there is no existence, just omit that step 6. Then after marking the adjacent ones, making the octet, quad, pairs, and even you have rolled the map, and even you form the overlapping has been everything being encircled. After doing, if there is a redundant group, remove that redundant group. If there is a redundant group, omit this particular rule 6. Next, after write the reduced expression, you have to write the solve the expression, reduced expression for all the groups, and after reducing, you form the OR, that is nothing but OR gate, that is OR sign, that is sum of product. You form a sum, that is OR, to the particular expression. This is the rules followed using your SOP in reduction of K-map. We'll solve a problem, then you come across what is this rules used in your K-map. Okay. See, the given expression f of function of a comma b comma c comma d, which is a summation of m. By this itself, it's a min term. Small m is used to represent the SOP. 0 comma 2 comma 7 comma 8 comma 10 comma 15. For this, first you draw the truth table. It is a 4 input. So 4 input, that is a variable expression. You draw the truth table. So here it is a, b, c, d. Next, you write it as in the form of by, that is final value, you write it as it is. Okay. Now represent, that is nothing but this is 1, 2, 4, 8. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, for 3, 0, 0, 1, 1, 4, 4, 0, 1, 0, 0, 5, 0, 1, 0, 1, 6, 0, 1, 1, 0, next 7, 0, 1, 1, 1, 8, 1, 0, 0, 0, 9, 9, it is nothing but 1, 0, 0, 1, 10, that is nothing but 1, 0, 1, 0, 11, 1, 0, 1, 1, 12, 1, 1, 0, 0, 13, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 14, 1, 1, 1, 0, 15, 1, 1, 1, 1. So this is the 4-bit, that is representation of a 4-input variable. That is, you take the 2's multiple, 1, 2, 4, 8, and you write this side from 0 to 50. When you count it, you get 16. So either go by 1, 2, 4, 8 multiples of 2. Otherwise, you partition half. I've already explained how to partition. That is a given possible values. Divide by half, place half of the 0's, half of the 1's. Again, divide by 2, that is half partition. Place 0's and 1's. Still you get 0, 1, that is divided. Still more you cannot divide, stop it there. That is another possible way of inputting. Or you go for 2's multiple, it will be very easy for you to represent. Next, in your midterm, the outputs are, for 0 it is 1. Only I am representing for only 1 output, that is which are the output. So, for 2 it is 1. Next, 1. For 7, it has 1. For 8, it has 1. For 10, it has 1. Next, for 15, it has 1. So, this is my 1's input, that is 1's representation of in a table, which has the expression, that is 0, 2, 7, 8, 10, 15. That is nothing but 1. Other thing, which is represented with zeros. So, for this given table, first rule, first you have to draw a truth table, then you draw a K-map for this. For this, we'll draw a K-map. So, 1, 2, 3, 16 squares. So, after drawing this one, you write the subscripted value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, next 12, 13, 14. So, you know, how to address 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now, to write the expression, what you have here, it is A, B, C. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. After representing this one, you represent in the form of the expression, that is A bar, B bar. A bar, B. A, B. A, B bar. Next, here is also C bar, D bar. C bar, D. C, D. C, D bar. So, this is the how to represent the empty K map, that is with its addressing and it's as well as the binary representation as well as the complement representation or the uncomplemented representation. Then, now you input your ones. That is nothing but this is M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, so on up to M15. So for this, first thing is 1, that is M0 as 1, place 1. Next you have 2, place 2, here it is 1, place 1. Next you have 7, 7 as 1, 7. Next 8 as 1, place my 8, 8. Next 10, 10 as my 1, 1. Next, 15, 15 as my 1. So, remaining places, you place 0. Put 0's, that is your third rule. So, after remaining places, now you mark for your adjacent ones, encircle the adjacent ones. So, here, first you have to see, when you encircle the adjacent ones, first you have to see octet, quads and pads. So, in the given K-map, there is no, that is nothing but adjacent ones is not nearby. But here one pair exists, that is your this one. When I have already told in a map drawing on, you have that is the opposite leftmost edges and your rightmost edges or corner of your squares get map rolled as you roll your paper. So this becomes your map roll. So if there is any map roll or overlap is there, you have to do that overlap and map roll. So here my quad one, the four ones when you rotate, as it is adjacent to each other, these two, it looks like a quad. So quad one is present, quad one, and quad one exists. So first we'll see for quad one. So you have to get the expression for quad one and quad one. So first we'll see for quad one, what are the expression? Quad one expression. If there is any exist in your redundant group, you have to remove. But there is no redundant group here. All are one group is not being overlapped by another groups of ones. So there is no redundant groups. One, you have to get the expression for quad ones and pair ones. Okay. So here this map rolling is there. So that is which forms quad one and pair one is exist. So quad one with a subscript value, that is M0 plus M2 plus M8 plus M10. Next up for pair it is M7 plus M15. So you have to write the expression. See, once again saying for quad bottle order, min term it is being possible is M0 plus M2 plus M8 plus M10. For pair it is M7 and M15. Quad one expression, see these two. A bar, B bar, A, B bar, C bar, B bar, C, D bar. When I go from vertically, A bar, B bar, A, B bar. So A bar, A get cancelled. Here it is left out to this B bar. Okay. Now when I move horizontally, these two. C bar, B bar, C, D bar. Same thing for this one and as well as this one. C bar, D bar, C, D bar. So here C bar, C get cancelled. B bar, D bar. This is my expression for quad one. Next, for pair, what's my pair is M7 and M15. So when you go horizontally, A bar A, A bar B, A B. A bar A get cancelled, the remaining one it is B. So nothing but B. When you go horizontally, that is nothing but B C D. So the given expression for the this particular min term is B bar D bar plus B C D. Okay, this is the given expression for the min term of the expression 0, 2, 7, 8, 10, 15. There is one quad and one pair. The quad expression is, that is B bar, D bar. The pair expression is B, C, D. After doing that, encircling one and performing the expression, now you have to join or you have to combine with your or sign. That is nothing but your plus sign. That is nothing but your SOP. This is the expression. Next problem we will see. The next example for your K-map using SOP is, that is f of a, b, c, d, that is equals to summation of 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So from this given expression, there are 4 input. So that is nothing but 2 to power 4 is nothing but 16 squares. First we will represent the K-map. So for this K-map, just draw the K-map here. 16 square K-map. So for this you address it. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and your inputting variable it is A, B, C, D. The binary representation for that is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. The variable that is complemented and uncomplemented is A bar, B bar. Next, A bar, B, A, B, A, B bar. Next, for your horizontal thing, you are going to represent it as 0, 0, 0, 1, next it is 1 1 1 0. Next you are going to represent it as C bar D bar, C bar D, C D, C D bar. See, once again I am telling, first you are draw the curve based on the input, that is nothing but 2 to the power of n, that is here 4 inputs, so 2 to the power of 4 is nothing but 16 square. Draw a map with 4 inputs with the 16 squares. Then you subscript that, they give the address for this, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. After addressing the minterms, then you represent in the form of binaries, that is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Yeah, that is your vertically, horizontally, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. This is nothing but my gray code representation. I have already explained how to represent this one. Next, you represent in the form of complemented and uncomplemented. 0 means here it is uncomplemented. 1 means it is complemented in your SOP. That is in your minterm. A bar, B bar, A bar, B, A, B, A, B bar. Next, C bar, D bar, C bar, D, C, D, C, D bar. Now, you represent all the outputs that is given in a summation of n, that is the 7. In place of 7, you place it as 1. In place of 9, that is nothing but 9, you place it as 1. Next, 10, you place it as 1. Next, 11, place 1. 12, place 1. Next, you have 13, 1. 14, 1. 15, 1. So now you form the next you have you form the quad, that is nothing but after remaining placing all your ones, you place it as zeros, remaining place is 0, that is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, here, okay. After placing this one, okay, you check for in a 16, that is your 16 squares, check for your octet, whether octet exists. Then you go for quad, then you go for what is the pair. So first you check where all of 8 ones are adjacent to each other, then you encircle that as octet. But here 8 ones are doesn't exist. So next you go for quad. Quad is nothing but 4 ones. So here I can make it as quad, one as this one. Or one, that is adjacent ones, one quad. Second one, this is my second quad. This is my second quad. Next you can, first you have to see all possible quad. Then only if it is a, if you cannot pair, you cannot insert the quad, then you go for a pair. Second quad is this one. So the remaining one it is here, that is N7, that is being paired with, you have been encircling with the pair with N15. So once again I am telling here, first you have given, what is that K map, that is given input, that expression. You first place it as 1, then the remaining boxes place it as 0. First you see for an, if it is a 4 input, you have to see for an octet. If 8 ones are not adjacent or encircled with an adjacent ones, then you go for quad. Here first quad it is this one. Next quad is this 4 thing. Next quad is this one. Then remaining M7 is left out. That can be encircled with a pair. So there are 3 quads. And one pair. For this, we will write an expression. First quad 1. So quad 1 is nothing but my N12 plus N13 plus N15 plus N14. So this is my first quad. Okay. For this, we are going to write the expression. My vertical it is AB. In a quad, I have already told, two variables changes its from its places, that is from complemented to uncomplemented or uncomplemented to complemented. So AB has it is, so here the, that is horizontally, horizontally when you move, that is nothing but C bar, D bar, C bar, D, C, D, C, D bar. So D bar get cancelled, C bar, C bar, C bar, C get cancelled, C bar get cancelled. So C, D, C bar, C, D get removed here, that is these two variables changes the places from complemented to uncomplemented or vice versa. So the required expression for quad 1 it is AB. So quad 1 is being solved. Next we will see for quad 2. So what's my bar. So here D, D bar get cancelled. So left out it in your vertical, it is A. When you go horizontally, these two, that is C bar, D, C, D. So C bar, C get cancelled, left out is D. So A, D. See, once again I am telling. See, I am working on this particular part too. My vertical values are nothing but A, B and A, B bar. So that is B bar, B changes from complemented, sorry, uncomplemented to complemented. So B and B get cancelled, the left out is A. When you go horizontally, these two, C bar, B, C, D. So C bar, C get cancelled. So it changes from uncomplemented to complemented or vice versa. So D. So my left out is A, D. So quad 2 is being solved. Now quad 3. Quad 3. What's my quad 3 tells me?
Next session will solve a product of sum simplification using KMAP. Thank you.